Hi guys, so I am doing something today that I am really, really excited about. I've been thinking about it for a while now and really wanting to get into it, and it finally just ended up happening, and that thing is getting a button press. So I'm really excited about being able to make my own art buttons, and I will be selling them pretty shortly on my store, but yeah, today is the first time that I'm gonna be working out some button designs. For the first little series that I'll be doing, I'm going to do at least four buttons that will be these magic potions and poison bottles. I am so excited about this. It's just something that I can get really, really creative with how they look, and there's just so many possibilities. So I'm really excited about this. It's gonna be a lot of fun, I think. The actual process of just like pressing the buttons and making this thing out of all these like odds and end pieces, it's just so pleasant and satisfying and a little bit addicting. I made a lot of stupid buttons the first day I had it, and that's okay. Hopefully I've got that out of my system, and now that I'm settling down and making actual art for the buttons, hopefully I can resist the urge to make buttons out of everything. I loved working on this little theme of these magic potions. There's just so many endless possibilities of what I could do for it, and it was just really, really fun, and it really got my mind working and imagining different things and thinking of different types of potions and what they could be used for and just different ways to show that in the bottle itself and the different effects that are coming out of the bottles, like the steam or smoke or whatever it is. This bottle that I'm almost done sketching right now, it was actually my favorite concept-wise. I really wanted to have this love potion, but show the darker side of it. It was something that I was really excited about. I remember the story that I read, I think it was like in middle school. It was one of those assigned reading ones, but basically there was this potion seller and this guy goes in because he's in love with this woman. And they say that they only sell two kinds of potions. One was a love potion and the other was poison. Anyways, and the point was is that you'd give someone the love potion and they would be so enamored with you and so in love with you that it would just go beyond reason and you wouldn't be able to handle it. And after the years of that, the only option would be to use poison on them and kill them. It was a good story. I enjoyed it. I'd like to find it again and maybe read it again. But anyways, so that was kind of going through my head as I was creating this, where these love potions oftentimes are kind of shown as more sweet and nice and lovely, but really, it's pretty dark, really, when you think about it. So I wanted to show that side of it. I also kind of channeled the look of the heart, the actual organ for this one. I also wanted it to be really cracked and a little bit beaten up looking, so maybe it looked pristine at one point, but this one's kind of been through something a little bit. Yeah, and in the end, while I was working on it, I brought it to like the finish stage where I was starting to work on finishing it up. It just wasn't quite working. The design wasn't nailed down quite right, and I was really loving it, so I wanted to be sure that this one turned out the way I wanted it to. So for this one, I kind of got a little ways into the painting process, but it wasn't quite working as well as I wanted, so I put that on hold until I could kind of sketch it out more and work out the design a little bit better. So then I went ahead and started just on my next button one, which was this little bottle of poison. I wanted it to be very clean and straightforward for this one. I just wanted it to be like your basic, typical poison. It does what it does. There's no extra frills or anything. It's just a poison. So yeah, I wanted it to be just very precise and clean. The painting process for this piece ended up taking so much longer than I felt like it should have. It was like 2 to 2.5 hours, I think, where it should not have taken that long if I had been, I don't know, more aware at the beginning, I guess. I'm not really sure. It's just one of those ones that just like drug on, and there was just a lot of fixing and changing to get it to the point that I did like it. So I guess all in all, it ended up still being worth all the time that it took to do it. But yeah, hopefully I'll learn from that and I can make my next poison buttons a little bit faster of a process. I did really love painting this, though, even though it ended up taking me much longer. I think that I learned a lot of different techniques that I want to include in my future series of this button, as well as other illustrations. I really like this, like, texture that I had in the background, where it had, like, this almost cross-hatched kind of a look to it, and that's something that I will definitely be continuing more of. I've been experimenting with that kind of texture for a little while, and I just really like it in this application, so I think that I'll definitely continue that in the series of buttons as well as everything else. I'm pretty excited about that. And I really like the painterly background looking thing. I don't do painterly very often at all, but I think that it works for this one, and I really liked it, so I'll definitely be bringing that in a little bit more and working that into my typical process more. All in all, I'm really happy with how this turned out in the button form. There's one little change that I think I'll make, is that the bottle and the background, they blend in a little bit too much from far away. I think they read okay up close, but when they're viewed farther away, it's hard to read it. So I think that I'll do something to make the bottle pop out a little bit more from the background. But other than that, I think this is pretty close to being ready to be put into production, and then I can get these pins up on my store, which will be open pretty soon. Thank you so much for watching, and don't forget to hit subscribe so you can see all my future art videos. And until then, I will see you at my next video. Bye!